Here we have a diagram of a tanker truck carrying hazardous material. As you can see, we have different areas labeled. The area inside the tank itself, as well as two areas outside the truck denoted by different shades of gray. Now, you might already be familiar with zones or classes and divisions for hazardous areas, depending on your geographical location. For example, in North America, we classify hazardous areas by classes and divisions. However, in Europe and Asia, we simply refer to these areas as zones. Now back to our diagram. Inside the tanker truck, you see we have Zone 0, or Class 1, Division 1. This means the hazard is present 100% of the time. Another example of Zone 0, or Class 1, Division 1, could be a chemical mixing application. So if we need a scale in this area, we need to understand the hazard is there all the time, and we need an appropriately protected scale. Outside the truck, in the lighter gray area, we have Zone 1, Division 1. Here's where it can get a little tricky because this is now a Zone 1 area in Europe and Asia, but it's still considered Class 1, Division 1 in North America, with the same protection required as the Zone 0 equivalent. So depending on your location, the required protection method might be different in this hazardous area. If you're in North America, it would require the highest level of protection, the same as inside the tanker. But other parts of the world are not quite as strict, as this is one level down from maximum protection. This area is typically where a load cell or indicator would be mounted. Now in the darker gray area, we have Zone 2, Division 2. This is an area defined farther away from the hazard. Under normal operating conditions, the hazard is not there. As a comparison for this area, think of your garage at home where you might store a gas tank. Under normal operating conditions, the hazard is protected by the tank. But if you have a spill, now it's a potentially hazardous area because if you have a spark, it could ignite. So once again, the hazard is not normally there, but it could potentially turn into a hazard. Now on top of zones, divisions, and classes, we also have groups for gases, dusts, and fibers. These groups help define what protection method can be used: explosion-proof, purged, or intrinsically safe. And we'll get into further detail on these protection methods in our next episode of Scale Talk. Thank you for watching. If you have a topic idea for a future episode of Scale Talk, please follow the contact information on your screen.